go into an Abaya shop, this is what you have. You have all these different options, all these different types of sleeves. See this? All these different things. You have some that are like this. See that? And then you have some where they'll have the embellishment go up the arm. And, you know, all different types of sleeves, embellishments on the collar. And they're all really, really nice. And so, you know, you have bigger sleeves like this. And the thing is when you get them, you can have them made the way you want. So what I did is I went through and I picked out the embellishments that I liked and the style that I liked, because you can get them really, really big, or you can get them really, really fitted. And I like a smaller sleeve, so I picked out my embellishments, the style that I liked, and they made it for me. So today I'm picking it up and I'm going to show it to you as soon as it's ready. They're steaming it for me so I can walk out the store with it. Hey y'all, it's Black Chicken Saudi again, and I'm going to talk to you about the Abaya. First, yeah, so this is the deal. Like, when I'm going out, like when I finish this video, I'm going to a Christmas party, and you can pretty much see that, you know, you wear what you want to wear. I got on my cute boots, got on my cute skirt. I'm trying to work it, right? But if I weren't going from one camp to the next, or if I were going anywhere in town, I'd have to wear the Abaya. And this is what the deal was with the Abaya. When I first, you know, I'm someone who feels like, you know, if I go out, you know, I have to be, you know, I have to be as cute as I can be that day, right? You can't be cute every day, but, you know, you try to work with what you got that day, right? As fabulous as I can be. So I figured when I first got here that if I am going to have to wear this Abaya, it has to be fabulous because, you know, I can't be walking around looking tired. But then I got here, and there's this whole big old thing I wrote about on my blog, but I was rushed to get my Abaya, and this is the one I got. And the thing was, when I got it, almost 2 years ago, that's how long I've been here. When I first got it, once I got here, I was so irritated that I had to wear it that I just didn't care, okay? I mean, I didn't care for it. I don't want to say I didn't wash it. I washed it a couple of times, right? I'm not going to snap this all the way down, but I just wasn't feeling it. You can see that it's wrinkled, and that's because I kept it in the car in the back seat, balled up in a pile, and that was my silent protest. I refused to earn it because it was a silent protest, right? This is my scarf, and if they made my cover my hair, you know, I'd have to do something like this, right? Now the Saudi women wrap it some kind of way like this. I don't know how to do that, but typically 99.9% of the time I have it like this. Well, now that I've been here and I'm back to, you know, getting over myself, I started noticing other Abayas. And then I don't like how mine is real tinty, right? And then look at it. See my boots? See how that is? I got about 5 inches off of the ground to the bottom of this Abaya. And that's a problem, people, because under this Abaya, you should be able to wear anything, even if it's just a bra and panty, right? I don't know that anyone's doing that. I'm not. But, you know, you should shorts or whatever. But with this Abaya, my ankle was showing. So now I've come full circle, and my feeling is if I gotta wear this thing, it has to be fabulous, right? In fact, this one doesn't even warrant. I'm gonna do it just like I was doing it before. I used to ball it up and throw it in the back seat of the car. That's what I did to it. But then I went and got one. So I went to 3 Abaya stores in Al Rashid Mall. I took a Saudi friend with me, and she let me know the ropes of what I could do, what I couldn't do, blah, blah, blah. And I found one, and this is the one I got. When I got this one, when I first saw it, it had bigger sleeves, so the sleeves were twice this length, and it was a little bit wider, but who knew that you could get them custom made for you, right? So this is my new Abaya, and you know, I think it's fabulous. It's not over embellished. My style is, you know, simple elegance, right? I don't like anything that's not tasteful. Not that I haven't dressed a little trashy in my day, but never too trashy, you know, because I got a mama and I got to be seen and I got a reputation to maintain, right? But still, I like the embellishments. So I got this, and I love this, right? Look at this. See, that's the scarf that you would wrap on your head. And so I would be wearing it like this, of course, but again, it's the same thing. If I were to wrap this around my head, I would wrap it in a way, if you know how the Saudi women wear it, I'd wrap it in a way that's kind of like this, where this would wrap around and this would come around, almost like in a perfect little point, right? I know I'm not doing this right because I can't see what I'm doing, right? But you kind of get the idea. But I wear it like this, and see the length? All the way to the ground. That's how it should look. And see how it's not as tinty? See, so it's, you know, it ain't form-fitting because it ain't supposed to be all like that, right? But it's big enough for me to wear like a sweater under it or something like that because it do get cold here, which is why I'm wearing these boots. These boots ain't a front. I'm going out tonight and it is cold. So yeah, this is my new Abaya and I love it. You see, it has the Swarovski crystals all the way around. Like that, I love it, which works because I'm always wearing silver. My wedding ring is in gold, but I'm always wearing silver. So I always wear a ring on my wedding finger, just so that people know I'm married, but I'm mostly wearing my silver. So that's why I decided on this color. And it's simple, but I love it. And that is the story of my Abaya. I want to give a shout out to First Choice. I think it's First Choice Stores. That's where I got my Abaya at. To thank them for letting me film when I was in the store. And